What's up, YouTube? It's your girl Black Cajun, and as I promised in the previous video, I'm going to show you how I filled in the numbers on this shirt. I showed you with the water bottle labels and the chip labels how I did this shirt. It's not showing up clear, so I'm going to have to upload it again. But anyway, I'm going to show you how I added his pictures into the shirt. Let me find this picture again. Not sure why it's so blurry. And I'm just having some trouble with my computer lately. Doing my drag and drop, it's just acting really. Kooky lately. I don't know what's going on. It's like flipping the picture for some strange reason. I'm just keep this one just for tutorial, for the tutorial purposes. So basically what I did was I typed in the number, click off of it, then click it again so you see these square boxes going around it. Okay, I'm just checking to make sure you guys can hear me. Okay, so once I do that, I'm going to go here and go to the this A with the line on the side. It is open the textile panel. So it's a textile panel. And the font that I'm going to use is Freshman, 'cause you know this resembles the lettering on the back of like football and basketball jerseys. And since he was part of their varsity football team, I use this particular font. Okay, so after I get this, after I get it to the font that I want, I'm gonna size it because as you can see, it's much bigger than the other letters. And I'm not gonna do the rest of this stuff. I'm just gonna show you how to do these custom letters. So after I get it to the size that I would like for it to be, I'm going to right click on my mouse and I'm going to hit ungroup. That separates each of the numbers into individual text boxes. So I'm going to select them all. I'm going to go here to do an offset. I'm going to hit offset. Now I'm just going to go with the. Oh, you know what? Before I hit offset, I want to let me go back. Before I hit offset, I want to duplicate these numbers and push them off to the side. I'll just push it down. So now I'm going to select them all and do the offset. Okay, and I hit apply to actually apply the offset. And then I'm gonna select the two, and it's gonna be both sections of it, the outer, and I'm gonna hold down the shift button and select that inner line. And then I'm gonna go here to the modify panel, and I'm gonna hit subtract. Crop. Sorry. Oh no, subtract was right. So when I go here and I add the color, you'll see what I've just done. See? Leave this open so that the picture can slide in. So basically, I'm gonna move this bad boy off to the side and I'm gonna do the zero. I'm gonna do hold down the shift button and go to subtract. And you'll see that it went to one line, but actually two because of the inside had to subtract as well. So I'm gonna control G G as in goat to group it. And I'm going to change the color. There you go. And to make it easy, you can just drag and to select both of them. I don't want the 8 to do your selections. This is what I want. Okay. I'm gonna change the color to this one as well. I mean, it's time consuming, but the end results are extremely pretty. And when we went to his graduation, if I tell you, we got stopped so many times. It was so many people at the graduation with custom t-shirts, but there was nobody with these shirts. And I actually was somebody because I had did a preview of his shirt like a couple of days before, and somebody on my sister and I tagged my sister and somebody on her timeline asked if I can make her a shirt for her graduation to celebrate because both of her parents are deceased, so she wanted pictures of her parents with her as she marched across the stage. So, but it wasn't exactly like his. I did the, but she did have the numbers. So I'm going to select all the numbers. I'm going to go to the align panel. And I'm going to hit this center vertical, the center, so they can be even across the center. Then I'm gonna hit this horizontal to space them out. Okay, wait a minute. I need to move this 8 over some. And I'll move the 2 over some and do it again. Okay. Now, mind you cannot, once you size this stuff and once you create these numbers and put the pictures in here, you can't resize. You can't resize this without resizing this. So if you have to, I'll show you how to resize it. But if you do, you have just screwed up your entire project and waste all your time because it's not going to work and it's not going to flow. Come on, my computer's going slow, so I'm gonna group them together so they don't move. And the next step is to create these beautiful pictures. So I'm gonna size this one up a little bit. And you want the numbers on top. So you wanna see the colored edges of the numbers on the top. We'll go a little bit higher. And my oldest sister was the photographer for his graduation pictures. She does a lot of our when we need pictures done, she does just about all of our professional pictures. And you just adjust it to how you want it. Then you're gonna select each of the pictures just by you can just do what I did and drag a box around them, or you can select the picture, hold down the shift button, and get that edge right there. And you're gonna go to your modify panel and you're gonna crop this time. And as soon as my computer catches up to what's going on, come on, computer, crop. There you go. My computer's going slow because I did not shut it off last night, and that is something you need to do every night. Shut your computer off all the way. And you just put it into place. I think I hit the side button a little bit too much. So, there you go. And you just go on with each of the pictures until you have completed it. This one needs to enlarge, even though it's a bit blurry. I'll just do it for the tutorial. And you crop it. Put it in its correct place. I may need to go over just twice. Oh no, yeah, one more. Okay, let's do the O. And you gotta kind of look at the letters and look at the picture to kind of figure out which one is going to work the best for each number. I don't know why I'm calling letters numbers today, but I'll blame it on my lack of sleep. All right, hold down the shift button. If you hear knocking in the background, just ignore it. It's summertime. I have 6 kids at home and my husband's at home. So, but good news is little mama is sleeping, so you don't hear her screaming, "Mama, mama, hold me through this tutorial." Okay. And for our last picture, this one is going to be, I think a little piece of his face is going to be missing, but that's okay. As long as you get the majority of the picture in there. And you just plop it in there. And this is how it would look on the actual shirt. Or whatever you choose to do. You can do this with numbers, alphabets. You can do it with shapes. It doesn't matter, you know, exactly what you use it with. But, and in order to print this out, now you're not gonna print this out like this. Now you could do printable vinyl, and you can set it and hit this button right here and just print it out. But to make it stand out more, you're gonna do this yellow part in a vinyl and print out the picture. And that's why I just put them in its place. If you need to size it up, size it, you're gonna select everything. To size it down just a little bit or size it up. That way you don't lose the integrity of basically like the puzzle pieces, because it's pretty much fitting like a puzzle. So in order to actually get this to work, you're going to take the number off and you'll size this down to 8.5 by 11. You just size it down to the 8.5 by 11, and you would print it out on printable vinyl, and then you would cut this part out later, as you would your regular vinyl pieces, and then you just heat press them one at a time, and that is about it. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comment section. I do answer questions, and I thank you guys for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell to get updates when I upload a new video. Thank you, and God bless. Goodbye.